Welcome back. This here is the Hologram Electronics Chroma Console. Now, a friend of mine bought this pedal. He's a guitar player. Obviously, it's a guitar pedal, right? So, he bought this for vibe and for tonal option, shall we say. But I got to looking at it and I thought, see on the back, you've got stereo in and out. And so I thought, what if I use this as a piece of outboard gear in a studio environment? Well, let me show you what it does. Okay, so, to lead us off, I'll give you a basic overview of the Chroma console. So, you have four different flavours, if you will, of vintage goodness. The first one is character, and then you've got movement, diffusion, and texture. Now, under each of these LEDs is five different versions. So, for instance, in character we have drive, sweeten, fuzz, howl, and swell. To select between each option, you just press the corresponding LED. So here we go, swell, and then you've got drive, sweeten, fuzz, and it will change colour depending on what it is you've selected. Looking at the top controls, these are quite simple. The amount, so essentially consider the bottom row as a mix knob for how much of the effect you want, and the top row has some individual controls, so tilt, rate, timing, etc. Now this does have USB on the back and 15 pin MIDI so that you can sync it over MIDI or USB time sync in your DAW, which is cool. We're not going to be bothering doing that today, I'm just going to time it as best as possible for the purposes of the demonstration. Now, here you can tap tempo if you're using it as a guitar pedal, or you can hold this down and it will capture, which means it will begin to loop whatever it is that you're playing. So you can actually use it as a looping pedal. When you very first set the console up, what you need to do is press both of these buttons together and play some source material through it, and that will automatically set the input sensitivity, which is good. So if you're switching, let's say you're deploying this on direct sources and you want to switch between them, that would be a great way to make sure that the input is being hit properly on the inside, so you're not getting too much of the effect, for instance. Now you'll notice that below here, you've got secondary controls, which is effect volume on this row, and you've got like drift and sensitivity here. Well, to access those, you just press them two buttons together, and everything lights up blue. That is now your secondary control. And you can adjust all of those individually as you so wish, yeah? And you tilt and you drift, etc. And you just hit bypass to get out of it. Alright, I've set this up on an internal bus in Pro Tools, so let's have a little listen to what it does on vocals.
I'm just a child of a mind. I just want to see her in her glory, in her dress that blinds the winter sun. Why are you afraid of death, yet you run away from life, burying your head just to get away from strife, leaning to the left though you know you're on the right, listening to me.
Super cool. So, as you can hear, I'm blending that in as a parallel send and a parallel effect. But it sounds really awesome. Let's put a send to it from the piano. Thank you. let's see how it sounds in the mix. Again, adds a really, really nice texture to it. Now, obviously, for the purposes of the demonstration, I'm using very extreme settings and I've got everything absolutely dialed up full send. But it's to give you a really pronounced sound of what this is doing. I mean, obviously, you can use this a hell of a lot more subtly than I am doing. Let's try it on the guitar solo. With the exact same settings that I was using before. If you ask me, this obviously shines on guitars because I think at its heart it is designed as a guitar pedal, so you put it on a guitar source and it just sounds incredible. However, let's have a little go on the drum bus as a send. Wow, that reverse effect sounds absolutely incredible. Let's try it on. In this track, I've got something really interesting. So, I don't know if any of you have seen on Instagram, there is this guy who's recording an acoustic guitar, like, stood up near a drum kit. Well, I thought, well, that looked like a cool idea, so I'll try it. And it sounds like this. You get the idea. You can use this on pretty much anything. Alright, let me zoom out and give you some final thoughts. And so there we have it. I just wanted to show you mostly that you can use this for alternative purposes than just guitars. As I say, it has got 15-pin MIDI on the back, as well as USB-C, stereo in and out, and an expression pedal as well. So, you know, you can kind of perform in a mix with this if you want vocal effects or drum breaks, drum sections, middle eights, all that kind of thing. There's so many different uses for something like this that, you know, if you've got access to one, it's certainly a useful thing to have in your toolbox. Now, would I recommend going out and buying one of these if you're a producer? Probably would, to be honest, especially if you're into indie genres and that kind of thing, because that's the bread and butter of this. Not only can you use it in tracking for guitars, but even after the fact, you can use it as an outboard effect. You know, you could use it on an aux send as a vocal effect, or, you know, literally anything. The mind wanders. You can add this on anything, and it sounds absolutely awesome. So, there we go. The Hologram Electronics Chroma Console. Awesome. See you next time.